Good afternoon to everyone. Before starting my lecture, I would like to thank our Dean, Dr. Bagal sir, and all the technical staff of MUHS and our principal madam, Dr. Patrikar madam, for giving me this opportunity to conduct this lecture. So today's my topic is concordance repertory. So concordance repertory, this is for all my UG students. This is a very important topic as this topic covers question number 1, 2 and 3. So the definition of the word concordance means, it means a harmony, synchronization or arrangement in alphabetical order of important words. The word concordance was first of all used by Dr. Bonninghausen in his homeopathic literature. Later on, it was replaced by Dr. Allen to relationship of remedies. Now, concordance repertory means the repertories which are based on alphabetical arrangement of symptoms of materia medica in their original form. These repertories belongs to the Puritan group of repertories. Now, student, this Puritan group of repertories means the repertories which maintains the purity of symptoms. That is, they are taken in the original form. So, the concordance repertory available to the homeopathic profession are two repertories. They are Gentry's concordance repertory and second one is Neave's repertory. So, we are going to deal first with Gentry's concordance repertory. So, the name of this repertory is the concordance repertory of the more characteristic symptoms of the materia medica by Dr. William Daniel Gentry, William D. Gentry. Now about this concordance repertory, Gentry's concordance repertory, as it belongs to the Puritan group of repertories where the symptoms are given in their original form without much change. Now, this Gentry's concordance repertory is the largest concordance repertory among these two repertories. The second repertory is Neave's repertory, but Gentry's concordance repertory is the largest concordance repertory because it is having 6 volumes. Now, there are 2 editions of this repertory. The first edition was published in the year 1890. And second edition came in the year 1892. So there are 2 editions of this repertory published in the year. So this may ask for 2 marks question, the publication year of this repertory. For all the undergraduate students, please note this. They may ask this for 2 marks question, the different editions of Gentry's repertory. Now how this repertory came into existence? Once when the author wanted to find out a remedy for the following symptom, the symptom was constant dull frontal headache, which was aggravated in temples with aching pain in the umbilicus. For these symptoms, the author had to search many materia medica books and repertory. So he claimed to form a repertory which was arranged on the Cruden's concordance to the Bible. It would have been necessary only to refer to the letter U and under umbilicus find out at once the desired symptom. So based on this Cruden's concordance to the Bible, the author has published or formed a repertory called as Gentry's concordance repertory. Now the silent features of this repertory. This repertory follows the Hahnemannian schema and it is published in 6 volumes. This repertory is published in 6 volumes, so it is the largest concordance repertory. There are about 420 drugs used in this repertory. Only 1 gradation is given in this repertory, and all the remedies are given in Roman and few are given in bracket. Remember, the 6 volumes are there of this repertory. It contains about 420 drugs. Only 1 gradation and all the remedies are given in Roman and few are given in brackets. Now we will see the plan and construction of this repertory. This repertory is given under 2 heads. First one is arrangement of chapter and second is rules adapted or construction of each chapter. Now we will see the arrangement of chapters. As this repertory contains 6 volumes, so we will see one by one all the volumes, what it includes. So volume 1, having 835 pages, it includes, or it starts with the first chapter, Mind and Disposition, Head and Skull, Eyes, Ear, Nose and Face. Second volume contains about 889 pages. It contains Mouth, Throat, Stomach and Hypochondria. Third volume contains about 930 pages. The chapters are Abdomen, Anus, Rectum, Stool, Urine, Urinary Organs and Male Sexual Organs. Volume 4 contains about 976 pages. It contains uterus and appendages, means its attachments, menstruation and discharges, pregnancy and parturition, lactation and mammary gland. Volume 5, having 956 pages, it consists of the chapters on voice, larynx, trachea, chest, lungs, bronchi and cough, heart, circulation, chill and fever, the skin, sleep and dreams. Volume 6, having 908 pages, contains the chapter on neck and back, upper extremities, lower extremities, bones and limbs in general, the nerves, generalities and keynotes. So this was all regarding the 6 volumes, that is, which was, as we know, the largest concordance repertory. So there are different volumes and it contains various chapters. Now the aim of this repertory. Now this concordance repertory is designed to supply the demand for a repertory which will enable the physician to find quickly and certainly any desired symptoms in materia medica together with its indicated remedy. Now, second point was, as we had seen first, the arrangement of chapters, and second was the rule adopted for the preparation of work. So we will see what are the rules given. The first, select and give all the more characteristics pathogenetic symptoms. Then include such clinical symptoms as we have been repeatedly verified only. When 2 or more remedies have the power of producing similar condition, include them as merely suggestive under the name of condition produced. Then how to use this repertory? As it is arranged alphabetically, definite divisions are given. It is arranged like an index or a dictionary. First, we have to use one physiological section, that is a word, which is capable of explaining the whole symptom or rubric. But if there is any difficulty in finding one particular word, then find out the synonym of it. Also, the main symptom is given in bold type, so it becomes easy for searching the desired symptom. Also, on the top of the corner, like a dictionary, words are given. There is no grading of symptoms. All the letters are given in routine letters. Only the first word is given in bold type. Now see, it is like a dictionary words where all A, B, C, D, all the dictionary words are given. Students, observe it carefully. Only the first word is given in the bold type, C. See my arrow? Then all the remedies are given in Roman, while few are given in bracket. This is regarding the Gentry's repertory. I had taken one page and this is just for learning purpose. I am showing you. See, all the remedies are given in Roman and few are given in brackets. Now, indication of this repertory. When we are not able to search a particular symptom, then when if there is a difficulty in translating the symptom of the patient into a repertorial language or rubric. Now we will see the scope of this repertoire. Very, very important part. This is asked for exams for undergraduate students. Scope of this repertoire or limitations of this repertoire, or they may ask as a long question too. So this topic is covered in question number 1, 2, and 3, as earlier said. Now we will see one by one the scope of this repertoire. The symptoms are given in their original form in Prewer's own language. That is why it is called as Puritan group of repertoire. Second, Hahnemannian schema is well followed. Symptoms are arranged in alphabetical order under each chapter. Rubrics can be found easily as first three alphabets are given on each page as well as in between each rubric. It is very useful for searching peculiar or complex symptoms. Then, cross-references are given in bracket immediately after the rubric. If we use noun, verb, or adjective of symptoms, even a layman can use this repertoire. So these were the rules. First, I had mentioned the rules adopted for this repertoire. So if we use noun, verb, or adjective of symptom, even a layman can use this repertoire. That's why this repertoire can be used as a reference book. Now, the very important part, limitations of this repertoire. It is just a reference book. Note down this. Many of the rubric consist of only one remedy and hence cannot be useful for systematic repertorization of a case. Not useful for bedside prescription as it consists of 6 volumes. Only one who uses the book should have a thorough knowledge of synonyms for the desired symptom. All the medicines are given the same grading. The abbreviations given for the medicines are different from other books. So these were the limitations of this repertoire. Now the references or the bibliography, the concordance repertoire of Materia Medica by William Gentry, textbook of homeopathic repertoire by Dr. Mohanty, fundamentals of homeopathic repertoire concepts, methods and technique by Ashok Kumar Das, essential of repertorization by S.K. Tiwari, and Reperire repertoire simplified by Dr. Khanaj. Now this was regarding all Gentry's repertory. Now second concordance repertory is Mead's repertory. The name of this repertory is Repertory of Herring's Guiding Symptom of our Materia Medica by Calvin B. Mead. Now the information regarding the Mead's repertory, it comes under the Puritan group of repertory. It is a concordance repertory published in the year 1896. Student, undergraduate student, please note down the publication. It may ask for a 2-marks question. It was published by Dr. Calvin V. Neer. Upon Herring's death in 1880, Neer became responsible for the completion of the 10 volume of guiding symptoms. Originally working with Dr. Charles Moore and Dr. Charles Raw, later working alone, Neer completed Herring's masterpiece in 1895. So Dr. Neer spent 5 years writing his 2 volumes of Repertory to the Guiding Symptoms, which came in the year 1896. So this repertory was published in the year 1896. The source of this Neer's repertory is very important part, Herring's Guiding Symptoms of Materia Medica. So source of Neer's repertory is Herring's Guiding Symptom of Materia Medica. Now the salient feature of this repertory, number of remedies in this repertory is 408. The chapters are 48. Arrangement of all the chapters is done in anatomical order according to the Hahnemannian schema till the 34th chapter. Remember this, till 34th chapter, anatomical order according to Hahnemannian schema is followed. Remaining chapters are the reaction of the whole body. First chapter starts with mind and disposition, and last chapter is drug relationship. So in Gentry's repertory, there were 420 remedies. In Neer's repertory, there are 408 remedies. Now the gradation of symptom. Different gradation is given in this repertory. Double thick line. See, double thick line, it denotes first grade symptoms, which means the symptoms are repeatedly verified. Single thick line, it denotes second grade symptoms, where the symptoms are verified by cure. Double thin line, it denotes third grade symptoms, it means the symptoms are frequently confirmed. And single thin line are the four grade symptoms, which means the symptoms are occasionally verified. So these are the gradation of symptoms given in this repertory. Different signs are even used in this repertory. Dotted perpendicular line, it means the observations are taken from the old school. Sign of T, it denotes toxicological extracts. Sign of theta, symptoms observed on the sick only. Now, while going through these different signs used in this repertory, in old edition, there was a sign of hand was used, which means cross references. Now, the next part, we will see plan and construction of this repertory. The order of arrangement or method of classification followed in the compilation of this repertory is the one inaugurated by Dr. Hahnemann, developed, perfected, and used by Dr. Haring throughout his entire Materia Medica work, namely the anatomical or regional division in 40 chapters. So the arrangement is given according to Hahnemann schema. The organ-wise classification follows the following order. That means the classification is done from above downwards, from within outwards, functional symptoms first, followed by the organic condition. And first the part and then the whole body. Now the different chapters in this repertory. Now see students, till 34th chapter, anatomical order or anatomical schema is followed. And from 35th chapter, reaction of the whole body is shown. Now one by one we will see the different chapters in this repertory. If this question is asked for exam, third question number 3, we have to write all the chapters also. We have to name all the chapters in detail. So first chapter, as it is mind and disposition. Second, sensorium, inner head. Fourth, outer head. Fifth, eyes. Sixth, ears, nose, upper face, lower face, teeth and gums, taste and tongue, inner mouth, throat, desire, aversions, appetite and thirst, 15th is eating and drinking, hiccough, belching, nausea and vomiting, 17th corbiculum and stomach, 18th hypochondria, abdomen, stool and rectum, urinary organs, male sexual organs, female sexual organs, pregnancy, parturition, lactation. 25th is voice, larynx, trachea and bronchi. Then respiration, cough and expectoration, inner chest and lungs. 29th is heart, pulse and circulation. Then outer chest, neck and back, upper limbs, lower limbs and limbs in general. Now, from 35th chapter, the reaction of the body is given. So, 35th is rest, position, motion, then nerves, sleep, time, temperature and weather, fever, attacks, periodicity, locality and direction, then sensation in general, tissues, touch, passive motion, injuries, skin, stages of life and constitution. And last 48th chapter is drug relationship. So these were the different chapters included in this repertory. Now, again, an important part of this repertory, the advantages of this repertory. It is useful as a book of reference to find the desired symptom together with the indicated remedy. Second advantage, the symptoms are given in their original form without much change. That's why it is called as Puritan group of repertories. Third, symptoms are arranged in alphabetical order under each chapter. Fourth, about 408 medicines are given in this repertory. Fifth, there are four grading of symptoms which help us to understand the relative importance of drugs in the concerned symptoms. The grades are given by different lines, that is double thick line, single thick line, double thin line and single thin line. So these were the grades of symptoms given in this repertory. Sixth is, since the cross-reference is given, one symptom can be referred to at more than one place. Seven, additional chapters are given in this repertory which are not found in any other book. Now, the disadvantage of this repertory. This repertory is not useful for systematic repertorization of a case. Note this. This repertory is not useful for systematic repertorization of a case. The abbreviations given for the medicines are different from other books. And this repertory contains less number of medicines. Now we will see what are the different uses of this repertory. This is based on concomitants. It is a repertory of cured symptoms. All the rubrics are very authentic as it is directly taken from Herring's Guiding Symptoms of Materia Medica. This repertory includes symptoms and remedies from clinical proving and toxicological pathogenesis. Thus, Neave's repertory can be used as a clinical repertory. Now see the uses of this repertory and how it is arranged. See the chapters and how the arrangement is given in this. See, it is arranged alphabetically. Definite divisions are given. It is arranged like an index or a dictionary. Alphabetical order is given. Then organ-wise classification follows the following order, that is from above downwards, Hahnemann schema till 34 chapters. Then first chapter is mind and disposition. See the different chapters given, starting with mind and disposition, then sensorium, inner head. So the Hahnemann schema is well followed, above downwards, within outwards, etc. So these are the different arrangement or how this repertory looks. All the alphabetical order, see the chapter contains, then starting with Hahnemann schema is well followed, starting with mind and disposition. Now see, cross-reference is given, one symptom can be referred to at more than one place. See, the cross-references are given in bracket. Top of the corner, like a dictionary, words are given. See, on the top of the corner of each page, the words are given, like A. Different words are given, like a dictionary. There are four grades of symptom which help us to understand the relative importance of drug in the concerned symptom. So these are the different grades where we can see. Then this repertory contains a lot of clinical rubrics. So they are albuminuria, apoplexy, etc. There are a lot of clinical rubrics included in this repertory. That's why it is called as a clinical repertory, or it can be used as a clinical repertory. Now, what makes it different from other repertories? How this repertory is different from other repertories? So, there are few chapters in this repertory which are not found in other repertories separately, like pregnancy, parturition and lactation, heart, pulse and circulation, limbs in general, nerves, time, attacks, periodicity, locality and direction, touch, passive motion, injuries, and stages of life and constitution. So this makes a difference from other repertories where these chapters are given separately in this repertory, while it is not given in any other repertories. Now, some clinical rubrics which are included in this repertory. This repertory has a lot of clinical rubrics specially associated to age, sex, and pathology. NEETS repertory is specially useful for clinical pathologies. Example, tissues, emaciation, convulsions, hydrocephaloid in. The remedy is zincum. Constitution, cachexia, and helminthiasis. The remedy is SENA. Heart, pulse, and circulation, blood, anemia, bright disease in acute. The drug is APIS. Inner chest, angina pectoris, fatty degeneration of heart with. The drug is Calmia. So these are the different clinical rubrics included in this repertory. Now the references are repertory of hearing guiding symptoms of Materia Medica, hearing guiding symptoms of Materia Medica, then textbook of homeopathic repertory by Niranjan Mohanty, fundamentals of homeopathic repertory by Ashok Kumar Das, essential of repertorization by S.K. Tiwari, then Reparai or Repertory Simplified Textbook by Dr. Vidyadhar Khanaj. Now, on present scenario, can we use this concordance repertory in the present pandemic of COVID-19? Use of concordance repertory in COVID-19 cases can be done as a reference book. Remember, it can be used as a reference book. So, use of concordance repertory in this COVID-19 cases will be helpful because concordance repertory contains rubrics in the layman language. While using this repertory, we need to consider the characteristics, pathogenetic symptoms, and also clinical symptoms verified in COVID-19 patients such as dry cough, throat irritation, breathlessness, fever, etc. So the concordance repertory, that is Gentry's concordance repertory, is designed to enable the physician to find quickly and certainly any desired symptom in the Materia Medica together with the indicated remedy. And volume 1 contains more. Chapters like mouth and throat can be referred from volume 2. Volume 5 contains chapters related to respiratory system. And hence concordance repertory can be useful as a reference book. Now NEETS repertory. This repertory is a reservoir of concomitants, cure symptoms, pathological and diagnostic rubric. Thus, NEETS repertory has preserved the symptoms in the original words of the provers, which makes it easy to serve. So the chapters which can be useful are chapter number 7, nodes. We can refer to coryza and nodes. Chapter 11, regarding test and tongue. Then chapter 13 is throat. We can refer to pharynx, swallowing, throat and tonsils. Chapter 26, respiration. We can refer asphyxia, breathing, dyspnea and suffocation. Chapter 27, cough and expectoration, where we can see or we can refer to cough, before cough, during cough, after cough, whooping cough and expectoration. Even chapter 28 contains inner chest and lungs, pleura and sternum. Hence, this repertory is helpful as a reference book. So this was all regarding both the repertories. Hope all the students understood this topic. It's a very important topic as exam point of view also. So thank you, all of you.